Jain everyone, so this is Ravi Saharan, founder and mentor of the WingLeader classes, and this is my third video in the video tutorial series. The first two videos many of you have watched and they have commented also and messaged me on Facebook as well. And it was a very common doubt that students wanted me to cover the most important and the most confusing part of SSB, which is the screening process. So in this video, I'll be telling you about the screening process. Okay. Before getting into what exactly screening is, kuch tips and tricks, what are the things you should keep in mind to get recommended, to get screened in, I would like to tell you certain myths and misconceptions as I always do for a particular test. So screening mein sabse pehle important thing here is, bahut sare bande, people, they generally get bogged down after getting screened out. Unko aisa lagta hai ki we are not able to get screened in, to hum recommend hona to bahut dur ki baat hai. So first of all, keep this thing in mind, this test is no way a test of your qualities. A small test, a test of where you will be writing a story and then narrating and discussing. This chote se test se koi bhi, chahe wo koi bhi assessor hai, chahe wo koi bhi banda hai, he or she cannot prove that you don't have the qualities. Screening ki shuruaat kari isle gayi thi kyunki the number of applicants and the number of aspirants increased. And we cannot accommodate everyone for a 5-day process at SSB. So we came up with a process wherein some people will be return back to their home on the very first day. So bus, this is just a, I would say, to decrease the competition or a crowd controlling process of SSB, nothing more than that. There are numerous examples where people who have already got recommended have got screened out, and there are examples where people who were not able to get screened in initially 3-4 times, they got screened in and they got recommended. So keep this thing in out of your mind. Alright, now we'll start with the process. So screening ka process, people who are repeaters, you everyone know what is the screening process. People who are new, you can, same thing I'll suggest you, I'll not give you the basic details, just find out the basic details what exactly the screening process is. Okay, so I am assuming that you are aware of or you have already researched. So we'll be starting with, everyone knows the first part of screening process consists of the written part, which consists of your test, the psychological test, the reasoning test, verbal and non-verbal reasoning. Verbal and non-verbal reasoning is, you can practice it from anywhere, you can buy any book or you can just practice sample questions from the net as well. That is done, we'll not concerned about that. I am concerned about the PPDT wala part, picture perception and description test. Okay. So PPDT part, you will see a slide, the slide will be hazier as compared to the slides that you see in TAT. The reason is just the same thing, because to get more and more ideas, so people, when the slide is hazy, so it's up to your imagination what you think. So to add that factor, this, there's a hazy slide. Also, it brings out, when you see a hazy slide, so what kind of story you are making, what kind of theme you are making, depends indirectly on your effective intelligence, the way you are thinking, and it speaks a lot about your thinking process. But we are not concerned about that. Generally, the slides, there are very few slides which are again and again getting repeated in the screening wala part. Even if they are not repeated, we don't have any problem for that. Now, important thing to keep in mind, difference between PPDT and TAT is what, PPDT mein you will get a hazy slide, TAT mein slides will be clear. PPDT mein you will have to give a title to the slide, TAT mein you don't have to give any title to the slide. You simply have to write the story. Time for both of them will be same, 30 seconds. You will see the slide in TAT and PPDT as well. 4 minutes to write the story. Now, in PPDT, the difference is that you will also have to mention the characters of the story, the slide that is shown to you. So you have the sex, the mood and the age of that particular person that you have to mention. So this thing is there. Now, again coming to the story wala part, the reason I covered the TAT part before was so that you get an understanding of what exactly, how you have to write a story. Now, try to see TAT, try to see PPDT in this perspective. This is a test, it's all about survival of the fittest. You might have all the qualities, lekin you have to cross this initial hurdle to get into the SSB. If you nahi kar paoge, tum screening nahi ho paoge, to tumne kitni bhi achhi taiyari kari ho, tum kitne bhi acche insaan ho, tum kitne bhi acche officer like qualities hai tumhare andar aur jo bhi hai, uska koi fayda nahi hoga. So just consider it as a plain, a simple test, nothing more than that. Don't take it in the personality wala framework that I don't have the qualities or aisa kuch. So there are simple tips which I always ask my students to follow. It's all about highlighting yourself, highlighting in the sense, it's all about marketing, survival of the fittest, wahi hota, everyone is good, but you have to be the best. So if there are 80 people reporting, there are 180 people reporting, there are 280 people reporting, the number of people who are getting screened in is the same, maybe 30, 40, 50, depending upon the batch strength, depending upon the number of people they can accommodate. So this thing you have to understand. SSB competition wala process nahi hai. Two people will not be just according to each other, they will not compete with each other. So if two people are good, they'll get recommended. It's not that who is better will get recommended. But screening mein this factor comes in, because no matter how many people are reporting, you have a fixed people that you have to take in. So the best people will be taken in. So screening mein, PPDT mein, you have to prove yourself. There you have to compete. So always go in the screening process, attend the screening process with this mindset that you have to prove yourself to be the best. Theek hai. Now, as far as TAT ki stories, PPDT ki stories or TAT ki stories mein kya likhna hai, kaise likhna hai, I have given a basic introduction in my second video lecture. You can go and visit if you have not watched it. In my subsequent lectures, video tutorials, I will be telling you specifically how to write different stories. I'll take an example and I'll explain you that. But now about the PPDT, I will stick to that. So suppose you see a slide and you write a story. Now after this, the next part is where, which is the most important part, writing the story is only 5%. Then when you go for your discussion and narration part. So you'll be there in a batches of 20 to 20 to 24, depending upon the board, they make batches. And every one of you will be asked to narrate your story. Now narration is the most important part. तुम्हारी स्टोरी अगर बहुत अच्छी नहीं है, बहुत ज्यादा कुछ आउट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड नहीं है, स्टिल एक्सेप्टेबल. बट इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू नरेट, देयर इज ऑफ देन देयर इज नो चांस दैट यू विल गेट स्क्रीन्ड इन. सी बेसिकली ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट एग्जैक्टली दे आर लुकिंग फॉर इन द स्क्रीनिंग का प्रोसेस. इन 5 मिनट्स का, 10 मिनट्स का प्रोसेस, दे आर जस्ट सीइंग दैट यस यू शुड, इट इज कॉल्ड अ मिनी एसएसबी एज़ वेल. दे आर बेसिकली लुकिंग दैट इफ वी कीप दिस पर्सन अगले 5-7 दिन के लिए इसको अगर हम रखते हैं बोर्ड में, सो ही हैज दैट कैपेबिलिटी, यस हां ही कैन गिव अस अ रिकमेंडेशन. They are ultimately looking for this. Agar tum us 5-7 minute mein during your narration and discussion and through your story, if you are not able to prove that yes, if I am worth there to spend 5 days in SSB. So just keep this thing in mind. Uske liye tumhe kya karna hai? You have to get highlighted. Highlighted in the sense, in a positive way. You have to show your qualities. They will not come to you. You will not say that screen me in. You have to show it through your different processes. So alright, so first you have written a story. Now let us not get into what kind of stories to be written, which we'll discuss later on. Suppose you have written a story, whatever story. Everyone is sitting in a group, you start narrating the story. Most important part. Narration, a very normal standard narration. ठीक है? ऐसा नहीं लगना चाहिए कि you are very much nervous, या फिर you are in a very much hurry, या फिर बहुत तेज बोलना है, बहुत धीरे नहीं बोलना है. You have to be casual. I always advise my students to be casual. Casual, not casual in terms of indiscipline, but be थोड़ा सा loosen up, थोड़ा सा आराम से, शांति से. Don't be, I would say, don't overburden yourself, don't overthink. Simply, the more light you are, the better performance you will give. Alright. So, you start narrating. So, for example, there are people, 20 people का group है, you start narrating the story right from your first chess number. Now, we'll imagine that I am sitting in the middle of the group. So, someone is narrating the story. First thing to keep in mind, if someone else is narrating a story, you need to focus or you need to listen to that person. So what you will do, now how to practice all these things, I will tell towards the end of the slide, end of the video. So suppose I am sitting here, some chess number, I am chess number 10, chess number 1 is sitting to my right and he is speaking. So I will just look at him and I will listen to him and I will try to see, I will try to understand what kind of story he has written, because that will help me later on. Similarly, now chess number 2, chess number 3 will, and then your turn comes. So you have listened to all the stories. Now when your turn comes, the narration should have a very standard subpart. Okay, gentlemen, the slide that was shown to us, I perceived 2 characters or 3 characters. A male, 25 years of age, approximately 25 years of age, in a positive mood. A female, negative mood, 23 years of age. And another person, who was a small child, appeared to be in a neutral mood and around 12 years of age. You cannot exactly guess the age. So you have to say approx, or you have to write 20 to 22. Just don't write 27, because you cannot exactly guess. The sex you can exactly guess. The mood also it is visible. But age still you cannot guess. So you have to always write it in this way. Even if you write exactly 26, 27, that is fine. Now immediately this thing should come. The moment you start speaking, jaise tum bolna shuru karte ho, the person who is sitting there as an assessor, he's a very experienced person. He'll immediately, within 5 or 10 or 15 seconds, the way you start narrating the basic introduction of the story, he'll come to know that yes, bande mein koi baat hai ki nahi. So keep this thing in mind. Wo jo first impression wali baat hoti hai, wo har jagah, har field mein kaam aati hai. Keep that thing in mind. Alright. अच्छा सो उसके बाद यू स्टार्ट नरेटिंग, यू विल गिव दिस बेसिक नरेशन, देन यू स्टार्ट नरेटिंग द स्टोरी. अब स्टोरी को अच्छा नरेशन करने के लिए क्या चीजें हैं, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट एवर यू हैव रिटन, लेट अस फॉरगेट द क्वालिटी ऑफ द स्टोरी. हो सकता है बहुत अच्छी ना लिखी गई हो तुमसे, बट योर नरेशन शुड बी वेरी गुड, नरेशन शुड बी कॉन्फिडेंट. यू डोंट हैव टू रीड द स्टोरी, यू हैव टू जस्ट टेल द स्टोरी, यू हैव टू यूज योर ओन वर्ड्स. सो द एसेसर हु इज असेसिंग यू, द एसेसर्स मस्ट फील दैट ही गेट स्टोरी भले ही बहुत अच्छी नहीं है, बट व्हाट एवर ही इज रिटन he is remembering that and he is speaking in a very confident way. So you have to narrate your story in a very confident way. Don't drag. Unke paas itna zyada time nahi hota, they will not give you more than a minute. Minute bhi nahi milti hai. In some cases, hardly 20 to 25 seconds. So you have to give your best shot at that. So simply start after your basic introduction. Okay, gentlemen, the story which I perceive were through characters, male, female, whatever this thing. Rajesh, a 23-year-old student, was studying in a village school and then start narrating the story. Come to the point quickly. Don't waste their time, they'll get bored, they'll throw you out. Second thing, important thing here is while narrating, first of all, hand movements. Ye cheez main hamesha bolta hu, I am moving my hand. You'll always see the people who are good speakers, or you must have seen people speaking in conferences or leaders, they are speaking, they always use their hands. No one speaks sitting straight. बहुत सारी जगह ये एक बहुत misconception है personality, body language को लेके, कि आपको हाथों का movement नहीं करना चाहिए. हाथों का बहुत ज्यादा movement नहीं करना चाहिए, but आप जितना हाथों को move करते हो, आप जितना confident होते हो अपने speaking में, slowly these things add to your power of expression. So, जो बंदा आपको जज कर रहा है सामने बैठ के, he will see that you are moving your hand. The body, indirectly, he'll have this effect that you are at ease and you are confident. So, move your hands. Keep this thing in mind. You can move your hands. Don't cover your nose. Don't cover your face with this. Normal hand movements you can do. Now, you are sitting in a group. It will be a semicircular group. There will be people there. Third thing to keep in mind is, while narrating, you have to have eye contact with the group. Don't look at the assessors. Eye contact with the group. So, if suppose there are people sitting, so I perceive three characters, one was a male 27 years of age, another female, look this side, look that side, it should appear as if a very friendly kind of this thing is going on, and straight away come to your this thing is done. Now next thing comes, your story is done, everyone has narrated a story, discussion of the story. Ek aur bahut bada misconception hai logo ke dimag mein ki एक स्टोरी आपको, यू हैव टू अराइव एट अ स्टोरी, और जिसकी स्टोरी चूज होगी, सेलेक्ट होगी, फाइनल स्टोरी बनेगी, दैट पर्सन विल गेट डेफिनेटली स्क्रीन्ड इन. ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं है, इट्स नथिंग लाइक दैट, दैट जिसकी स्टोरी द ग्रुप एग्रीज विल डेफिनेटली गेट स्क्रीन्ड इन. सो डोंट हैव टू फाइट फॉर दैट, ठीक है. ऑल यू हैव टू डू इज यू हैव लिसन टू एवरीवन्स स्टोरीज, यू हैव टू गिव अ हेल्दी डिस्कशन. और हेल्दी डिस्कशन क्या होता है, write for your GD also, write in your group planning also, write in your this thing. A person, a healthy decision, a healthy discussion hota hai jisme you listen to people, you express your views, if you are cutting someone, or if you are trying to convince something, you convince him logically, and if you are impressed by someone's point, if you are not impressed by someone's point, you have a logic, you have a counter to give in a very polite way. Okay? Again, keep in mind the survival of the fittest. So moment every last person thinks, if you are going as a fresher, I can still expect ki bahut zyada group mein bhasad nahi machegi, lekin if it is a repeaters group and if it is a TGC entry or it is a army ka entry or the direct entries, bahut sare bande aate hain, definitely bhasad hogi. So again, survival of the fittest. So what will you do? You have to participate in discussion. Keep this thing in mind, you have to, there is no way out. If you don't participate, you are out. So start participating in a discussion. Initiation, sab bolte hain ki we should initiate in a discussion. Very true, you should initiate in a discussion. But initiation does not mean that you have to be the first person to speak. For example, in a group, suppose four people start speaking ek saath. Char bandon ne ek saath bolna shuru kiya. Theek hai, tumne bhi bolna ek saath shuru kiya. Jaise hi aakhri bande ne apna narration khatam kiya, tumne bolna shuru kiya. Teen bandon ne aur ne bolna shuru kiya. Tum char bandon ne. So all of you, all four people. Initiated it, लेकिन चारों एक साथ तो नहीं बोल पाओगे, किसी ना किसी एक को ही मौका मिलेगा. तुम्हारा काम यहाँ पे हो जाता है. You have to initiate, you have to try to speak. It is not necessary that you are the only person who will be given the. So हो सकता है तुमने बोलना शुरू किया, लेकिन किसी और बंदे की आवाज तेज थी, या फिर उसकी पोजिशन ऐसी जगह पे थी कि सबका ध्यान उसकी तरफ गया, या फिर तुम्हें खुद भी लगा कि हाँ ये कुछ लॉजिकल बोल रहा है, तुम रुक गए. तो इंपॉर्टेंट इज यू हैव टू शो इनिशिएशन, ठीक है. Second thing is at least 3 to 4 times. Healthy discussion मतलब कि keep this thing in mind, at least 3 to 4 times you have to speak. ये तुमको हर जगह बताया गया होगा, all the classes that you have attended, all the blogs, whatever you have read, everyone must have told you this thing, initiation and speak 3 to 4 times. So initiation का फंडा मैंने बता दिया, speaking 3 to 4 times. It depends what kind of discussion you are doing, GD hai to kis type ka topic hai, group planning mein to what is your plan, if you have anything to speak or not, PPDT mein you have written a story, ho sakta hai ki tumhari story hi sabse achhi ho, and you are very much convinced ki sabse achhi story meri hai, to immediately you will have more points to speak. Let us imagine two cases where you see that your story was not very good, someone else, for example chess number 3 ki story bahut achhi thi, immediately chess number 22 stops and you start the discussion. Okay gentlemen, I think the story which was suggested by chess number 3 was the best one, because then you give a logical expression. Always keep this thing in mind ki abhi to jaise main bol raha hu, tum log soch rahe ho sir abhi to aap bata to rahe ho hum ki aisa mein bolna chahiye, lekin jab group hota hai to wahan pe itna aasan nahi hota, ab to aap aaram se bol rahe ho, to wahan pe aisa nahi hota definitely. Maine bola ye ki bahut sare bande ek sath bolna shuru karenge. Keep this thing in mind that if you are trying to speak and you're speaking for example chess number ya fir apne group ke sath, they are not the assessor, assessors are sitting there, they are seeing you. So if you are trying to speak and someone else is not allowing you to speak, but at least you have tried, and whatever you are saying, that assessor is listening, and he is the person who will make you get screened in or screened out. So keep this thing in mind. यहाँ पे कोई सुने ना सुने, लेकिन वो बंदा जो assess कर रहा है, assessors are definitely. So don't get bogged down कि मेरी कोई बात सुन नहीं रहा है. ठीक है? This thing to keep in mind. So the first point that should come out of your mouth should be something of this sort. I think gentlemen, or I think friends, we should go with this story. It can be your story or it can be any other story, because then you give a logical expression, a logical reason, because I think the background of the slide was matching with what with the village wala story, with the village wala background, and he suggested a village wala story, so we should go with his story. Ek baar tumhara ho gaya, the first point should be basically this thing only. Now kisne suna hai nahi suna bhul jao. Try to understand the human behavior, human nature. The assessor is a human, he is looking, usne sun liye tumhari baat, yahan pe koi sun nahi pa raha, koi fark nahi padta hai. This thing should be there. Okay. उसके बाद ऐसा होता है कि there are 2-3 चीजें तो तुमको पता है, अब आगे कैसे बोलोगे? Always keep in mind, try to give someone else, ये भी तुमने बहुत बार सुना होगा GD में भी, कि किसी और बंदे को बोलने का मौका दो. Definitely GD के टाइम पे चीजें काम आती हैं. PPDT की स्क्रीनिंग में इतना टाइम तुम्हें नहीं मिलेगा कि कोई बंदा नहीं बोल रहा, ऊपर से ग्रुप इतना बड़ा होगा, किसी को तुम चांस दे रहे हो कि let him speak, कुछ करने की जरूरत नहीं है. फॉरगेट ऑल दिस, सिंपली गिव 2-3 लॉजिकल पॉइंट्स, गिव अ गुड नरेशन एंड 2-3 लॉजिकल पॉइंट्स. ठीक है, वॉट एवर यू आर स्पीकिंग, say it logically. So suppose you are saying, I think what he is saying is not correct, or I would say that his story is, my story is better as compared to this, or we should favor this story, or in the slide we saw that there were two people and it appeared as if there were kettles also in the story. So tumhara kaam hai ki tumhe ye logical points dene hain. 3-4 logical points tumne de diye with confidence, tumhara screening ka kaam ho gaya. Keep this thing in mind कि जो रिटन टेस्ट होता है दैट डेफिनेटली काउंट्स, लेकिन सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट इज दिस नरेशन एंड डिस्कशन. इवन इफ योर स्टोरी इज नॉट वेरी गुड, यू स्टिल गेट स्क्रीन इन इफ यू आर गुड एट नरेशन एंड यू आर गुड इन डिस्कशन. अच्छा, इफ पॉसिबल व्हेन यू स्टार्ट प्रैक्टिसिंग पीपीडीटी में वी शुड अवॉइड मेकिंग स्टोरीज विच आर वेरी जनरल. सो TAT में लेटर ऑन एज आई टेल यू देयर आर सम स्टोरीज, न्यूट्रल स्टोरीज, प्लानिंग अ टूर और ट्रेवल और पिकनिक, ऐसा कोई छोटी मोटी एक दो स्टोरी अगर आ जाती है and you have a hobby of touring and traveling, everything is there, it's still acceptable. Usse zyada wahan pe bhi acceptable nahi, ek ya do se zyada nahi, lekin PPDT mein since you have only got one shot and it's all about survival of the fittest, as I have told you, you have to try to write a story which is thodi si challenging. What is a challenging story? What is a story that stands? In my first, second video I explained actions, theme kuch extent tak theek rehta hai, help karta hai, but it is your actions that speak about your qualities. ठीक है, सो कीप दिस थिंग माइंड. ट्राई नॉट टू मेक अ स्टोरी ऑफ अ नॉर्मल पिकनिक पार्टी वाली, घूमने फिरने की स्टोरी. गिव अ हीरो सम चैलेंज, इवन इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू करेक्ट लॉजिकली टू द स्लाइड, थोड़ा बहुत इफ यू आर डिस्टॉर्टेड चलेगा, एटलीस्ट इन PPDT. TAT में नहीं, TAT में बिकॉज स्लाइड विल बी क्लियर, डेफिनेटली वहां पे लॉजिकली यू हैव टू कनेक्ट, लेकिन यहां पे तो कीप 2-3 थिंग्स इन माइंड. ठीक है, बंदे कहां पे गड़बड़ करते हैं इन सब चीजों में. अब उसके बाद है कि प्रैक्टिस. तो सी, अगर आपने तुमने कोई क्लास अटेंड करी है, तुम SSB की कोचिंग वगैरह कहीं पे गए होगे, बैच है, तो ठीक है, तुम 10 दिन 12 दिन वहां रहते हो, 7 दिन वहां रहते हो, 3-4 बार तुम्हारा PPDT होता है, ग्रुप डिस्कशन होता है, इससे ज्यादा मौका नहीं मिलता है. ठीक है, तो तैयारी अब कैसे करनी है? SSB की कोई भी आप अगर तैयारी कर रहे हो या फिर किसी भी ऐसी ग्रुप एक्टिविटी की, तो वेन यू आर गोइंग टू अटेंड सम क्लास, तो आपको थोड़ा ही मौका मिलेगा टू प्रैक्टिस 3-4 दिन में. इफ यू आर ऑलरेडी गुड, ग्रुप डिस्कशन तुमने करे हुए हैं, डिबेट्स तुमने करी हुई है, देन इट इज फाइन. बट इफ यू आर नॉट, we have not done any such this thing, so wo jo 3-4 din ka experience exposure milta hai classes mein, that will not help you. theek hai, even for the students who come to me, agar main bhi unko group mein karwata hu to 3-4 din mein it will not change anything, you will just get a basic idea. It is your practice that will make you perfect, And this thing what I told you that I'll tell you how to practice. So akele rahke bhi, even if no one else is there with you, you can do that. There's something called visualization, jo ki visualization simply naam se suggest hota hai ki you imagine something, you imagine a scene happening and you try to act according to that. So when we used to do flying in the academy, so suppose tomorrow I have to fly. So aaj main apni sortie practice karunga. So we used to do chair flying. So we used to sit on a chair and we used to close our eyes. We used to have that, we used to imagine that we are sitting in a cockpit and we used to recreate the whole scene at that, and we used to close our eyes and imagine that we are doing the circuit and we are doing all those flying wala stuff jo bhi tha. So if you do this two, three times, it was very easy when we used to get in the into the real cockpit. So you have to go, you have to train your mind. So agar aapke पास कोई दोस्त नहीं है, कोई तीन चार बंदे नहीं है जिनके सामने आप लेक्चर कर सकते हो या फिर कुछ कर सकते हो, यू कैन स्टिल डू इट ऑन योर ओन. करना क्या है, कुछ नहीं करना है, बेसिक फंडा वीडियो देखकर तुम्हें समझ में आया बेसिक फंडा. उसके बाद कभी भी खाली बैठे हो जस्ट सिट ऑन अ चेयर, इमेजिन देयर आर फाइव पीपल दिस साइड एंड इमेजिन अ फिश मार्केट सिचुएशन, इमेजिन अ काम ग्रुप, इमेजिन अ सिचुएशन वेयर योर स्टोरी इज द बेस्ट, इमेजिन अ सिचुएशन वेयर योर स्टोरी इज नॉट गुड, समवन एल्सस स्टोरी इज गुड, ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ परम्यूटेशन एंड कॉम्बिनेशन लगा के एंड जस्ट imagine and try to do. So यहाँ पे तीन चेयर रख लो, चार पांच चेयर यहाँ रख लो, imagine they are people, now someone is cutting your point, now you are giving your rebuttal. So the thing is you have to recreate that scene. फिल्मों में भी देखा होगा. तो ये चीज जो है it definitely helps, क्योंकि कोई भी बंदा हो जो अच्छा है जिसको स्पीकिंग आती है वो तो बंदा निकल जाएगा, लेकिन जो बंदे नहीं है, this is specifically for them, जो बंदे ने क्लासेस भी अटेंड कर ली है लेकिन क्योंकि वहां पर कम एक्सपोजर मिलता है. So keep this thing in mind. Same thing you can go for lecture it, same thing for GD as well, same thing you can go for I would say PGT, HGT ke liye bhi. I ask my students to follow this thing. Theek hai, 2-3 din tumne practice kar li, sab kuch ho gaya, lekin wahan pe imagine karo ki worst case scenario kya hoga. Group mein koi tumhari baat nahi sun raha, how will you put forward your point? Koi tumhari baat nahi sun raha, ya fir koi sun raha, ya fir tumhe idea nahi aa raha hai, ya fir interviewer has asked you this question. Jab main interview ka questions cover karwaunga, that it is very important. You imagine, या फिर ask one of your friends to ask you question, or just imagine, or always practice it in a थोड़ा सा harder form. So you are answering something, an interviewing officer is not listening to you, or he is cross questioning you. ये सारी चीजें तुम्हें, if you go through your imagination, you visualize करके करोगे, slowly, all these things will get down to your subconscious mind, and through your conscious mind will come out during the SSB. So keep this thing in mind. So a quick revision, what we learned, screening ka test does not show that you don't have qualities or not. It is just survival of the fittest. It is a race. You have to win it at any cost to go to the second stage. Test ko sirf test samjho. Ko bahut zyada character mein ghusne ki zarurat nahi hai. Keep this thing in mind. Then, uske baad kya karna hai tumhe? Things to keep in mind. Write a good story. Don't write a choti, ghumne firne wali story. Write a story which has actions. Even if logically puri tarah connect nahi kar pa rahe ho, एकदम इलॉजिकल भी नहीं, अगर गांव का सीन है तो गांव की ही स्टोरी बनानी है, ऐसा नहीं कि तुमने उसको शहर बना दिया, कुछ और बना दिया, लेकिन कीप दिस थिंग इन माइंड. सेकंड थिंग इज नरेशन. नरेशन के लिए क्या चीज है, ग्रुप के साथ आई कांटेक्ट होना चाहिए, यू कैन मूव योर हैंड्स, इट एड्स अप टू योर पावर ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन. थोड़ा सा कैजुअल बट डिसिप्लिंड, सो आई वुड से इन अ लाइट मैनर, लाइटली होके थोड़ा सा करना है तुम्हें. डिस्कशन के टाइम पे अगेन हैंड मूवमेंट्स, यू कैन से चेस नंबर्स, यू कैन मूव योर हैंड्स ऑल्सो. बहुत ज्यादा एग्रेसिव नहीं होना है, 3-4 बार बोलना ही बोलना है. एंड ये सारी चीजें कोई काम नहीं आएंगी, कोई तुम्हें नहीं सिखा सकता जब तक तुम खुद प्रैक्टिस नहीं करोगे. उसके लिए मैंने तुम्हें बता दिया विजुअलाइजेशन वाली थिंग, जस्ट विजुअलाइज एंड प्रैक्टिस. इफ यू आर गुड यू विल बिकम बेटर, इफ यू आर नॉट गुड यू विल बिकम गुड. दिस इज द ओनली वे आउट. ठीक है, सो वी आर डन विद द बेसिक इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ एसएसबी, बेसिक इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ टीएटी एंड स्क्रीनिंग. नाउ इन माई नेक्स्ट वीडियो आई डोंट नो वॉट आई विल बी कवरिंग, आई विल सी वॉट पीपल वॉन्ट मी टू क्लिक टू कवर. बट वंस यू आर वॉचिंग द वीडियोज, वंस If you watch one video, you can see that you will be connecting it to other videos. So people who are watching this for the first time can watch my first 2 videos, then come to this video. Or in my next video, maybe I'll cover PPDT wala, the TET wala part in detail, or I might cover something else as well. So keep practicing. Yes, you can message me. You have, people are already messaging me on my Facebook wala. You can keep messaging me. You can visit my Facebook page, WingLeader by Ravi Saharan. Simply type it, you will get that. Subscribe to this, like it. If you want to leave any comments for improvement, leave there. And that's it. So keep preparing. Jai Hind.